Buster's Scout Band and senior bandmaster of the whole tour, how the mass band was made.
The 1977 National Mass Scout Band is made up of three bands and part of another. The three bands is the 2nd Brighton Scouts, Marching Ambassadors, the Burgess Hill Scout Band, and the 14th Southgate Band from London. The others are a few members of the full Scout Band who have come along to help us fill in where necessary.
How were these bands selected to take part in the tour?
Well, I was first asked by Mr. Peter Ingram at headquarters to form a mass band, and I suggested to him that I have the three top bands from the Scout Association. They are the top, the National Champion Bugle Band, the National Champion Trumpet Band, and the National Champion Open Class Band. And that's how we selected them. We did need a few others to help us, and as we were going to this area, we asked Paul if they would also help us out with a few members, which they did.
What is the itinerary for the tour?
Well, we started off at Plymouth, where that's where we first met. We hadn't practiced together at all. We knew what we wanted to do. We'd been in touch with each other, and I told each bandmaster. We then met at the Royal Marines Barracks at Stonehouse in Plymouth, and we put the program together on Saturday afternoon and Sunday morning. Their first performance was on the Saturday afternoon. Actually, well, Sunday afternoon. We'd done two performances at the home. Then we went to Bristol and we performed there outside the town hall. Very impressive. And now, of course, we come down here to Portsmouth, where we've been rained off. But we hope tomorrow will be a better day. After Portsmouth, we go to Brighton for two performances. Then off to Trafalgar Square another.
Peter Chapman from the 14th Southgate Band. You're the senior drum major for the tour. What exactly does this job entail?
It entails leading the whole of the mass band and also getting together with the other two drum majors who are in front of the band and coordinating all the movements with them so it looks smart. The front three drum majors do exactly at the same time. It took us about an hour to work out what exactly we were doing before we could go on parade.
How hard a task is it to actually lead the band on parade?
It's much harder than leading a single band, but apart from that, it's not much more difficult.
Do you have a written plan, or is it all done from memory?
We didn't know what the parade was going to be until we got together Saturday to practice it, and from then on it was all new to us. We had to keep it in our heads for what we were doing, so we had to learn it virtually right from the start.
What sort of reception have you been getting from the public on the tour?
Very good reception. It's surprising the number of people that turn out on sometimes very dull and rainy days that we've been getting lately.
As Gordon Stoner mentioned, the Wednesday evening performance in Portsmouth Guildhall Square was cancelled because of the rain. But the following afternoon, undeterred by a near gale force wind that almost blew some of the smaller bandsmen off their feet, the National Mass Scout Band performed in the South Sea Castle Arena.
Thank you.
from Portsmouth back to